बिल्डिंग अ टीवी ऐप विद फ्लटर इज एक्चुअली वेरी इजी बिकॉज इट्स जस्ट द सेम ऐप विद अ रिस्पॉन्सिव लेआउट, बट वॉट अबाउट गेस्चर्स? टीवीज डोंट सपोर्ट गेस्चर्स, सो इट्स एक्चुअली अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग टू टैकल इन फ्लटर. यू जस्ट नीड टू मेक यूज ऑफ थ्री थिंग्स: शॉर्टकट्स, फोकस एंड एक्शंस, एंड यू कैन यूज देम टू नेविगेट योर फोकस ओवर द ऑन स्क्रीन कंट्रोल्स. सो हेलो पीपल, दिस इज निशित दीक्षित, एंड एज यू कैन सी इन दिस वीडियो आई हैव ऑलरेडी हैंडल्ड सच सिनेरियो. एंड टू कीप इट सिंपल टू अंडरस्टैंड, आई हैव मेड अ बेसिक प्रोजेक्ट विद मिनिमल यूआई एलिमेंट्स सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट बेटर. आई विल बी यूजिंग ओनली थ्री थिंग्स फॉर दिस: फोकस, एक्शंस एंड शॉर्टकट्स. एंड लेटर इन द वीडियो आई विल ऑल्सो शो यू हाउ यू कैन रिफैक्टर द कोड and make it proper utilities so that you can use it for every screens. So as you can see here, this is the basic Flutter starter project. I have made some changes to this. This is the basic app, my app, and here I changed the title of it. And in the my home page, I have defined an icon named selected icon, which will be changing with time. And here I have a column. Column means I will be aligning items. So first item is expanded, first children for the item is expanded, and the second children is row. So the row consists of four elements. In a row below the column there are four containers. Containers are just to show a border and an icon. All the containers have different icon here, and I have also defined a border for all of them. So you can see it here, icons have the borders, all the containers are decorated with border. This is the design you can see here. So these border will be used to show the current focus, and rest of the containers will not be showing the border, which will not be in focus. So here we can toggle the state of border so that we can display the current focus on which container has the current focus. And as you can see, the app is currently running on Chrome because it's just a basic app, and then we will be running it on TV emulator. So this main icons in the center will be changed as we switch the focus. So we can see the task to be performed, and we will handle the actions on the key press, or we can say the intent, while we press the D-pad keyboard. Okay, so let's now return to our project. This is the basic UI, and now we are going to modify it. First thing we need to do is focus. So for focus we have to do some changes. First of all, we need to make notes. So here I am making notes. I just named it icon 1 focus node, icon 2, icon 3, and like that. So you can name something else, but to keep it simple and understandable I just use this. So these are four nodes because we will be having four components that can get the focus or that can request focus. So focus nodes are the nodes that can use to get the focus. We have four nodes in this screen, and we will write we will cover each container with focus widget, and the property focus node will be passed the name of the node. For the first icon we will be passing icon 1 focus node, and I will be doing the same for all of the containers. All the containers will be wrapped with focus widget, and I will pass the node. So I have done with the focus part. I also need to get the focus on start. As now we can see nothing is changed because the border doesn't disappear. So I can toggle it like if the icon for focus node has focus, then we can do something, or else we can do something. So I am going to do like, I will be showing null if it doesn't has a focus, and the border if it has the focus. So that's it, format it. So here we can see icon for focus node has focus with not, means it doesn't has focus, then we will be showing null, and if it has focus then we will be showing the else condition, that is border. So I am going to apply this on all the nodes. Okay, so now we can see the no elements has the focus, so no border is displayed. Now we need to request the focus. So what we can do is we can make a method for it, set first focus when the build method is first initialized. So I will be calling first focus. So here I can say if icon one focus node is equal to null, means it is not yet initialized, then I will be initializing, because I need to keep track of the initialization of the focuses. So let's not initialize all of them here. I will be cutting them. I will just simply copy all of these here, and now I should remove the initialization from here. And now because of null safety, I need to make them nullable, so I will use question mark here. Yes, okay, paste here. So all these icons are initialized. If icon 1 was not yet initialized, that's totally fine. So now I am going to request focus. As soon as these icons are initialized, focus nodes are initialized, I will request the focus to focus node 1, means the first icon will be having the focus as soon as the screen starts. So focus node focus scope dot off context dot request focus, and I need to pass the node here. So I will ask for the first icon, icon 1 focus node. Okay, and I need to call it from somewhere, but it will be needing the context of build context. So I need to call the method inside of build context. So I have write the if block here, and that's totally fine. I can call the if block because of the condition, so it will be calls only once and it will not create any problem. So if the icon one focus node is null, then set for first focus will be called. And here is our another method to change the focus every time. We will pass the context, we will pass the node, and it will request the focus for that node. Also, don't forget to dispose the nodes that we have initialized. So it's just like controller. So what I will be doing here is I will just same for all the focus nodes. Icon 1, 2, 3, and this one is 4. So all these, we are almost done with the focus part. Now we need to do two things, shortcuts and actions. So for actions, what is there? Okay, because of null. So I think not being mandatory. So yes, I keeping false safe value, fallback value. So false. Either it will be null or it will be false, whatever the value will be. We'll change all of the focus nodes. Okay, so now let's first run this so that we can see focus should be on the first icon. Yes, so we can see here the focus is on the first icon, and if we want to change the focus, we don't have any system yet. We can hard code it and check if it is working for every focus. So we do not have any place to call this change focus function. The focus is on the first one right now. Let's check for the focus on second node, icon 2. It should be shown. Yes, the focus is now here, so it will work fine. we are done with the focus part. Now let's integrate the other thing. So we need to add actions and shortcuts. What should we add first? It's actually somewhat clumsy process if you feel like, but it's very easy. So let me minimize all this. We can see all the focus nodes. So we need actions for all the focus nodes and shortcuts for the parent. So I'm applying shortcuts over the column. So here I will be writing shortcuts. Is this one? And I need to make a map here. You can see the property of this. One property is shortcuts. Shortcuts, and it will ask for a map. So which type of map? Map of logical key set and intent. So I'm gonna copy this and paste it there. Yes, and the map. See, it is throwing error. Yes, because we don't need to mention the map keyword here. Okay, it is the map now. What we can write inside of it is the buttons we need to handle. So we need to define here which buttons we are going to handle and which intent to be called. So I am here writing logical key set, and then inside of which we need to define the key. So logical keyboard key dot, here we can see different keys. So let's first write arrow left, logical keyboard key dot arrow left, and an intent. What are the intent? Intents are basically nothing, just extends an abstract class. We can understand it like it's just the callback that will be called when the key is pressed. So we will be making the intent later. It's very easy. Let's first define all the keys here. So we need to handle 5 keys. Yes, you can see here arrow left, arrow right, the arrow up, down, and the select. Select means the center button, the round button, circle button. So I am defining the name as enter button intent for the select button. So now is the time to manage intents. So we should be defining them globally. So out of the class, out of any class, we will be defining intents because they also extend abstract classes. Over the home page, now I am here defining. This is the definition of intent. We have defined all the button intent that extends a abstract class name intent. That's it for the shortcuts. We are done with the shortcuts, and all the actions done in this shortcuts will call the respective intent. And for every focus, our intent will be calling different callbacks. So for each focus, we need to define which intent will call which callback. Means for one action we need to have different logic, for second action we need to have different logics. So wrapping the focus inside actions, the third thing we need to use actions. So I am here just wrapping the focus. Wrap with widget. Actions, action, maybe this one, and inside of which we need to define actions map. Actions, what is the problem? Okay, I think that's not action, it's actions. Yes, it's actions. The child is required and it is asking for a map of type and intent. So means the type of intent and the callback. So I will be defining the map here. Yes, we are done with the actions. Now we need to define the callback for particular this focus item, and we need to do this for all the focus items. Let's first do for this only. So this is our icon one, and we can say if we press the right button on the keyboard, then we need to move to the second icon focus. So we will focus the second icon. We are here, and now we need to move to the second icon on press of the right button, this way. So okay, so now we define the type of intent here. The type will be of right button intent that we defined earlier, and this right button intent will have the value of a callback action. Yes, the it's actually very easy, just need to do it for once only. Here is a function that we need to invoke. On invoke means when the button is pressed while being on this object, while the focus is on this object. So we will just call this function that we have made earlier, and we will request the focus to the next icon, change focus, and we will pass the context to it, and the node for the node we will pass icon 2 focus node. Okay, so that's it for the right button. Now we can easily say okay, there is some null safety issue. We can make it nullable, or let's this not be nullable because we need it here, so we should promise there that is it will not be null. So exclamation marks is there. Okay, so we have handled the right button while the focus being on the first icon and the right button is pressed. It will request the focus according to this callback. It will request the focus to the icon 2 focus node, and that is fine. We don't need to handle other buttons for this focus because it's the leftmost element in the UI. For the center elements we will be handling both the keys left and right, and for the last element we will be handling on the only the left button intent. So let me do that faster. I'm going to do this for all the focus items. I will wrap them with the actions and show the action here. So now I have here managed both the left and the right button for where it is needed for the left and right, and where the control is needed for the right or the left only. I have managed that. Let's launch a TV emulator. Yes, we need a TV emulator for this, and let me also show you where is the keyboard that we get to control the keys. So this is the TV, and you can click on three buttons, and here you can see three dot icon, and here you can see the directional pad. This is the keyboard D-pad key that we call, and here you can see we can have the control over the screen. Let me show you by controlling some. So it opened the select app. The control is on the app right now. It's watch next. So this way the TV works. I also forgot to mention intents here that thrown an error. So yes, obviously this is a callback that gets an intent and returns the method. So it's done now. Yes, we can see here, and now okay, it will work fine. Yes, we need to also set the state after every focus change, because the focus is also a change notifier, but it will work inside of it. But we need to handle over the all the focus nodes, so we need to handle set state for it. So let's write set state after this line of code that is requesting the focus right here. So just we need to write set state for every actions. That's it. All right, let's restart the app and see if it works. It should. Yeah, the app is restarted now. Yes, okay, so we can see we can navigate to the different focus, and we need to now change the icon that is on the main screen. We have defined the selected icon, so changing this arrow function to block code and setting the selected icon every time we change the focus. So selected icon will be the button we press. If we are 1, we are at 1 and we press the right button, then the selected icon will be icon 2, something like that. It's totally depends on the use case, how you use it. But we can also make a list and we can say the list icon index next or previous one. I am just for the demo purpose, I am doing this. This is not actually the recommended. You should make a list if you are using the list of icon again and again. I will also show you how you can make this code easier to read and easier to manage for bigger projects, because it is going big and big for small tasks. So as you can see here, yes, the application is reloaded and it should now change the icon. Yes, it is changing the icon. You can see here, if I click the button, the main icon is also being changed. So I hope you are getting the idea of what we have done and how we have done. If there is any doubt, you can mention it in the comments. And before doing the further work, I would like to say that you can also suggest me the topics you want me to cover. As you can see here, the shortcuts it's written. We can make a separate class for it. I have done it. Let me paste that class. Make a folder named whatever we name. I name it utils, because it will be a utility for our app, and we will be using it throughout the app. So action handler class, which has the method handle arrow and enter actions. The naming is also very important to understand what the method is going to do. So you can see it here. You can pause the screen and copy the code. Now instead of just this shortcuts and all, I just need to call the method action handler dot handle arrow and enter actions. Okay, we can also make it more easier to read, because we are using focus and the border container etc for all the elements in the screen, just because of an icon inside of it. So we can pass the focus node and the icon that we want to show, and it can be handled easily. So we don't need to write this much code again and again. Let's refactor this, make a separate widget for this. Okay, I make this widget custom focus, and taking the child from the call. When we call the method, we will be providing the child and focus, changing all the places. Now is the time to move this class from here to make a separate utility, because it is also being used again and again, and it is just a utility. So custom focus dot dart, and I am pasting it here. So we need to import material dot dart, ओके इट्स डन एंड वी नीड टू कॉल दैट क्लास हियर इम्पोर्ट. ओके सो आवर कोड इज नाउ लिटिल बिट शॉर्टर, बिल्ड मेथड गॉन शॉर्टर एंड इट इज ऑल्सो नॉट नीडेड. इंटेंट्स वी हैव डिफाइंड इन द एक्शन हैंडलर्स. येस द कोड इज नाउ क्लीन एंड यू कैन सी इट इज ऑल्सो मैनेजेबल फॉर ऑल द स्क्रीन्स. आई होप यू हैव लर्न समथिंग फ्रॉम दिस प्रोजेक्ट. You can see here it is working totally as it was working before refactoring. There is no problem. So this was the video and I hope everything is fine. I am not providing the code because it is just I am not providing the repo because it is just a code that you can understand easily. Thank you.